An NFL star who took his own life is making sure that he leaves a lasting legacy. Dave Duerson's last wish was to donate his brain for research on a degenerative brain condition known as CTE. The disorder is linked to repeated head trauma and has become common among athletes who suffer multiple concussions. CTE can lead to dementia and depression. Joining me now is ex-wife of the former NFL star, Alicia Duerson. Good morning to you, Alicia.
Good morning.
And our condolences to you on the loss of your former husband. I know that you have children together, and this is a very difficult time for you.
Yes, yes.
But I know you wanted to speak out because you received a text message from Dave shortly before he took his own life. What did it say?
The text message basically said that he loved us, he loved me, he loved the kids, that he really felt there was something wrong with the left side of his brain, and for me to please get it to the NFL.
And at that time when you got that text message, had he ever sent you anything like that before?
No, never.
And so you were concerned?
Never. I was very concerned because it was a weird message. I got it, my phone registered about 2:53 Chicago time. And when I woke up at 6 and saw the message, I immediately responded and I could not reach him. Then I called my son and we talked about it, and my son also tried to reach him. And then when we got the news at 1 o'clock in the morning on the 17th, Dave was gone.
So he shot himself, but he left this suicide note as well. Here's what it says. Please see my brain is given to the NFL's brain bank.
Correct.
Obviously, you're going ahead with doing that, and they will do research on it. He had suffered multiple concussions, right?
He had. He had suffered in college and in the NFL in his playing career. Mm-hmm. And there were probably times that he never even might have mentioned it to us, but I'm sure it was more than a couple of times.
Alicia, as you know, this is such a hot topic right now because the NFL is very involved in trying to make sure that the safety of players is paramount. I understand that your son also plays football, and Dave wanted to make sure that he had a special kind of helmet that was concussion-proof, or at least helped to not just limit the amount of concussion?
Yes. My son graduated from Loyola Academy in Wilmette, and then he went to Notre Dame his freshman year and was a football player. Mm-hmm. And before Dave took him to the campus, he explained to him that he had to get that helmet and he had to wear that helmet. He didn't have a choice. He had to do this, and he did. Mm-hmm.
So obviously you're going to honor what your ex-husband wanted you to do. Where will this research
be?
Go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm just wondering where the research will be done.
The brain now is in Boston, at Boston University, and they're doing the research on it now. Mm-hmm. They are in conjunction with the NFL to find out what is going on with the brain with these athletes. And Dave would be the first brain. I take it that they got it in time, in that window where they can examine the brain and really find out what's going on with the brain.
Well, obviously, they will probably learn so much. And as I mentioned, this is such a hot issue right now that so many people are talking about. We appreciate your thoughts on this morning.
Thank
Alicia
you.
Duerson is your
and
greeting.
I just want to say one thing else. It's not just NFL. I think people need to put the attention not just to NFL, but also to college and Little League. I mean, we don't really know what's the cause of these things, but these kids hit each other at such a strong force.
Right.
I think everything should be examined.
Very well said. Alicia Duerson, thanks for being our guest.
Thank you.